And there are two correct answers here, and that is the second answer and the fourth answer. And the reason for that is as follows. If you manage to have a polynomial time reduction from a problem x to a problem y, that means that you can take any input to the problem x and then use y to solve it. What it does not mean is that you can take every input for y and use x to solve it. The reduction is only one way. But that means if you manage to reduce a problem x to a problem y, then solving y must require at least as much effort or power as solving x. So that means that y is at least as hard to solve as x, and not the other way around, as I just said. Now, on the other hand, since y is at least as hard to solve as x, that means if you find a way to solve y in polynomial time, then of course you can also solve x in polynomial time, because this reduction here takes polynomial time, and then solving that problem would also take polynomial time. On the other hand, if you can solve x in polynomial time, so this problem here, that doesn't really mean anything for y, because as we just said, y is at least as hard to solve as x, but it doesn't have the same hardness or is easier in any way. So this implication here does not hold true, and those two are the only ones that are true. Now, if this quiz confused you a little bit, I find a good way to memorize this, what a reduction from x to y means, is that if you have a reduction from x to y, that basically means that this problem x here must be able to fit into the problem y. And that is why this problem y here is in a way larger or harder to solve than x. So you take this problem x and put it into y. That is what a polynomial time reduction can be pictured as. And at least for me, that's very helpful. And of course, I do hope that it is for you as well.